samples of metals and non-metals. Here I have certain metals. This is iron. This is aluminium. This is magnesium ribbon. This is zinc granules. This is copper wire. Iron wire. These are samples of metals. Then you have certain non-metals. This is pencil lead made up of graphite. Then you have charcoal. We have this carbon black, which left as ashes or coal when you have wooden pieces and you burn it. Then you have phosphorus, which is present over the matchstick. This. Then you have phosphorus on the surface of this matchbox also. These are examples of metals and non-metals. Then we have properties. Metal can be stretched into thin wires. That is, they are having a property. They can be stretched into thin wires. You have seen this is aluminium wire. It can be converted into thin wire. Then you have magnesium ribbon. It is again converted, stretched into thin ribbon. Then you have iron. Iron can be stretched into thin wires. Then copper wire we are using for electrical connections. This can be converted into very fine, very thin wire. That is, this property is termed as ductility. Metals, those which can be converted into wires. That's why they are termed as ductile. Then with the help of hammer, metal can be beaten into thin sheets. Metals can be converted into thin sheets with the help of hammer. On hammering, iron converts to thin sheets. That's why metals are termed as malleable. Malleable means those which can be beaten into thin sheets. Metals can be molded into different shapes due to malleability and ductility. You can see all these instruments made up of iron are having different shapes. That's why metals can be used to make different operators, different things, as they are having property of malleability and ductility. Then you have another property. Metals can conduct electricity. You have seen this copper wire. This copper wire is used to make electrical connections. Why? Because it is good conductor of electricity. We have one exceptional case of non-metals. That is this. Pencil lead. Graphite is also good conductor of electricity. That's why it is used to make electrodes in cell. You must have seen dry cell. Dry cell is having a graphite rod in its center. That's why we can say this is exception to non-metals, which is conductor of electricity. But all those non-metals are not conductor of electricity. Even they can't be converted into thin wires, or they can't be converted into thin sheets. As if you can see, it is brittle in nature. If you will try to hammer it, it will not convert to thin sheets, but it can be broken easily. This is brittle in nature. Then one more property. Metals can conduct electricity. Metals are very good conductor of electricity. For that, we need to do one activity. We will take a candle, ignite it. Then we will take iron nails. Take this candle and put one drop of candle wax on this. Then we will take iron nails. 6 iron nails are pasted with the help of candle wax like this. Now we will take this iron rod and start heating it from one end. You will see that candle wax will melt when this iron rod will get heat up by the process of conduction that you have studied in class 7. So first iron nail fell off as heat has reached till first iron nail. As the particles of wax are getting heat from the surface of metal, they'll start falling off. Yes, second nail fell off. In this way, all the nails are getting heat from the surface. One by one, all these nails will fall down. This is by process of conduction. That is, metals can conduct heat by the process of conduction. Particles of iron are getting heat energy from the candle, and one by one, all the iron nails will fall off.